What is going on, peeps? Welcome to the 9th episode of the main story in Let's Play Lost Odyssey here on the Xbox 360. We're inside Cooke and Mack's house, and well, it is time to go meet their mommy. Hello, mommy. Let us go see what she has to say to us. Looks like she's laid up in bed. And I'll shut up.
Hey, Mom. Mom, we're home. Mom, we brought some guests.
Is she sick?
Looks like it.
Good afternoon.
Hey there.
These people are from Uhra. They protected the tender flora from these stupid soldiers, didn't they?
The flowers.
Mom? What's wrong?
Mom?
The flowers. They've let me see you one more time.
The flowers. They brought us together.
Oh, Father.
Father?
What?
Father?
Liram, is that you?
Liram!
Liram!
You survived.
Kaim, your memories.
What is it? Why are you looking at me?
Gongora. Gongora was there.
I've missed you so much.
I'm so sorry. I couldn't save you myself.
Is Mom?
I don't know. I haven't seen her since. Sarah. I have to find her. She doesn't even know you're alive.
I don't have much time. Cook. Mack. Come here. Listen, both of you. Kaim here is my father. I know he looks very young, but he is your grandfather. The one I've told you so much about. Your dear, dear treasures. I've been able to hold on this long because you've been here. Father, take care of them, please.
Of course.
Father, there's something I've always wanted to tell you.
I know, Lirum. I know. Lirum!
Mom! Mom!
I'm glad. So very glad. I could see you once more.
Mom!
Lirum! No, don't go. I'll bring Sarah here, I swear. Hang on, Lirum.
Mom! Mom! Mom, no! No! Mom!
And all I can say to that is, what a twist! Never mind. Anyhow, we have taken control of, what, Tolton, I think his name is, but well, we really can't do much. We're in a forced cutscene. We can run around the amphitheater here. And, well, more cutscenes will shortly be revealed to us here. Let's just run around. Yep, can't go in here, but we can come up to, what, this big statue? And once he starts talking, I'll shut up once again.
Father. If only I had a fraction of your strength. There was still so much I needed to learn from you. I depended on your guidance, even when you scolded me for my weakness. Father!
Was that creeping up on him? You want to know, folks? Uh-oh. I think we've seen this thing before.
What is this?
Another! What a twist! Uh-oh, four of these monsters coming at us. Let's just battle them up here. And we get to learn, yes, about, well, the Prince of Uhra, I guess he is now, the Tolton.
Stay back!
And he's very cowardly, apparently. Well, let's go ahead and use Cut Down. And that'll hit every one of them. He has some pretty good abilities, but first... he's gonna get beat up a little bit, I guess. The slow shambling mudmen. They're zombies made of mud!
Better brace yourself.
And we killed two of them. Not too shabby. Let's go ahead and kill the other two. We'll save some of Tolton's powers. And yes, you don't have to worry about timing events with him right now. As this is, like I said, just a good old-fashioned introduction to Tolton and more story. Give a guy a heart attack. Wow, level 25. He's much higher level than us right now.
chairman.
You fought rather well. I'd expect nothing less of you.
You were watching. Why didn't you help me?
Well, I didn't expect a frail puppet like that to best someone of your blood. I sent it simply to test you.
Huh?
Do you understand what I'm saying?
What? That puppet was one of your pawns? Why would you do something like that to me?
Because I do not wish to see the throne restored.
Throne restored? Wait, was the poison soup your doing? Chairman, answer me!
Oh, some rather ominous music playing. We've heard that before. Well, I guess we have to battle Chairman Roxian now?
I cannot trust Uhra to the hands of an incompetent ruler!
An incompetent ruler! No, we just get to inquire.
Is that why you tried to kill me?
As long as a member of the royal family exists, dissidents will try to restore the monarchy. The royal bloodline must be extinguished!
It must be.
Just by being alive, you give those dissidents hope!
Oh boy, more inquiries. So question-filled, are we, Colton? Another prayer.
But I do not wish to have the monarchy restored, Chairman. There is no reason to kill me.
I will not stand for incompetence. There is only one way to atone. You must die now!
You must die now! More inquiries. And another flare. Colton just stands there and gets blasted.
Chairman, this is madness!
If you are made king, Uhra will fall!
Well, finally we can attack him. Let's go ahead and cut him down.
I see no other way than to fight. Forgive me, Chairman.
Oh, he's gonna burn us again. We'll cut him down to size!
Brace yourself!
Monarchy is no longer the right choice!
Wait again here. Let's hit him with a power hit now. I do believe this'll do it.
What have I done?
What happened?
Gongora!
Oh, I am too late.
Oh. He's dead? I had no choice. The chairman was trying to kill me.
I know. I know everything. All right, let's deal with this calmly, Your Majesty. Please, don't panic. Roxian visited my manor earlier tonight. He spoke enthusiastically of his plans to prevent the restoration of the throne, to establish his own influence and such. To achieve those ends, he said the first thing that had to be done was to ensure Your Highness's death. I sensed peril, and although I am under house arrest, I escaped my incarceration and came as soon as I could. But I was still too late. I would never have expected the chairman to try to kill you, even as deluded as he was.
Gongora.
Chairman Roxian died in an accident.
You always come when I'm in danger. You are the only one I can rely upon.
Your Majesty, I believe your late father watches over you and sent me to your aid.
Father.
Let us go now. I will handle everything. Your Highness will not be suspected.
Oh.
Drink this. It will calm you a bit.
Right. Oh. What should I do? I've killed a man!
Perhaps your memory is a bit muddled. It was an accident. Chairman Roxian passed away due to unfortunate circumstances.
But...
The chairman fell prey to a sudden illness. It was beyond the doctor's abilities to save him. Leave everything to me. I will announce the chairman's sad demise to the people. No one else will be hurt. No one will question Your Highness's integrity, and the chairman's good name shall be preserved. Consider this. If our nation lost both the chairman and Your Highness, it would plunge into chaos. If that were to happen, Gotsa would undoubtedly take advantage of our weakness and invade.
Yes, Gotsa would.
Remember, they have plotted against Kent and wore down Uhra during the recent war. If Uhra were to falter now, it would be an invitation for Gotsa to invade.
What should I do?
There is only one thing Your Highness must do, and that is to protect Uhra.
Me?
Yes, Your Highness. Like your father, you must lead your people with confidence and conviction. It is your solemn duty to overcome the incident that occurred today.
That is true. It is my duty. Gongora, will you stand by me?
Always, Your Highness.
If it weren't for you, Gongora, I don't know what I would do.
You sell yourself short. You are an able administrator, and you will one day be a fine king. Now then, today you must rest. Beginning tomorrow, you will be a very busy king.
And wow, we've learned that, well, I guess Gongora takes after Randy Orton, and that is, he's like a snake. Randy Orton's the viper.
Kaim, Argonar, from this day forward, you are my servant. Give me a sign of your fealty.
Welcome back, Kaim.
I think I'm gonna be sick. If Gongora wiped out our memories, he must be up to something.
So he took our memories, instead of taking our lives. By taking away what was most precious to us, he destroyed our hearts and reduced us to empty shells. If he's willing to go that far, what he's after must be this world.
The world itself.
Yes.
Ridiculous. Me, you, Gongora. I remember two others. One of them is Sarah.
The other one is Ming, the thousand-year-old queen who founded Numara.
Does she remember?
I don't know. When we were released, we only got a glimpse of her face.
I'm going to look for Sarah.
Any ideas where to start?
In my memories.
That is true. The way you feel about people is different from memories. Feelings of love become a huge sense of loss when your memories are sealed. Those you've loved remain in your heart. You'll be able to meet her again, I'm sure.
I've stumbled upon my daughter's death twice now. The first time she died, my heart was filled with despair. The second time she died, though, it wasn't despair that filled my heart. It was hope. If he won't die, I'll bury Gongora in so much pain he'll wish he was dead. We have all the time in the world. That's the hope that I live for. Liram helped me to live again.
Ah, they all live happily ever after.
Kai, if the send-off tomorrow is too hard for you to bear...
No, I'll see Liram off. It's my duty as her father.
Good morning. You must be Miss Liram's father. Miss Seth contacted me.
Where's Mom going?
She will return to Mother Ocean, who brought us to this land long ago. Even though her body goes to the sea, you will still have your spiritual bond with her.
Spiritual bonds?
Yes. Your souls as mother and son will always be connected. Even though the body may have gone, these bonds are eternal. I'll need the family's assistance to give Miss Liram a proper farewell.
What should we do?
It's nothing difficult. We'll need flowers to adorn Miss Liram.
I understand. I'll get lots of flowers, so Mom will look extra pretty.
Then, if you would take care of the torches, please.
You all right?
Yeah, but I want to do something too.
Certainly. I'll have you help me later. Well then, the first thing is to gather the flowers, please.
And yes, now it is time to begin. Well, after we read this, 10 flowers, white flowers for decorations. I'll show you where one of them are. You can see these things are what we'll be collecting. And I'll be getting the rest of these next time when I play more of Lost Odyssey here on the Xbox 360. I certainly hope everybody enjoyed this cutscene-heavy episode. I want to wish you all the best, and you all have a great rest of your day. Thank you for watching.